We are back here, Money Matters Midday, talking with Lisa Wessan, resiliency and longevity expert. She's also an author, an inspirational humorist, a seminar leader, a counselor, and a coach. She's a television host, The Lighter Side of Transformation. The website is mirthmaven.com, and you're all about making people feel good about themselves.
Yeah, well, that's a process. You know, it's a cliche to say, "Oh, let's feel better," but you know what? You've got to do your inner laundry, so to speak. It involves forgiveness work. It involves having more compassion for yourself and others. And where the laughter comes in, Chris, is laughter is an accelerator of these emotional phenomena. So, you know, if you're feeling bad about something, it's been my experience when people sit in my office when I do a keynote. When somebody laughs and then they start crying, have you ever had a laugh and then cried? Maybe, well, guys don't do this as much as girls. Laugh and cry and laugh and cry.
No. It's Kate, do you do that? Kate Davey, my producer. You've laughed.
Isn't that the best? It's very cleansing.
Are you sad when you cry, or are you laughing so hard you start tearing up?
You're both.
Well, sometimes when people laugh, they hit a point where they feel the absurdity and the incongruity and the paradox of their life in such a deep place, and how crazy life is. Life can be nuts. And instead of being a victim, when you laugh, you feel like, I'm going to get past this, even though it's insane.
Right.
And you cry out of joy and also grief. It's a very interesting phenomenon. There's a point in laughter where you disappear in a way. You just feel this oneness and this emptiness. And I actually have a great quote I want to share with you about
Please. This.
Because it's one of the few quotes I carry with me. I really should memorize it, right?
Osho, or get a tattoo.
Get a tattoo, even better.
Yeah.
Osho said, the philosopher and mystic, laughs that your whole body, your whole being becomes involved. And suddenly there will be a glimpse. For the moment, the past disappears, the future disappears, the ego disappears, everything disappears. There is only laughter.
And very nice, very beautiful.
That's a place in time where some people want to meditate, and you know, meditation is great. I'm not against it. I meditate myself. But some people can sit quietly and just do that for 15, 20 minutes. Well, can you imagine some people use laughter as a form of meditation because it gets them to that place of stillness and oneness and quiets the mind. And actually, one of my first exposures to this work was a guy named Laraji Nadananda in New York City. He does a laughter meditation program that is a knockout. And that was before graduate school even. I was like, oh my God, I want to do more of this. Because I experienced a tremendous freedom in the 2 hours of intense laughter.
It's very awesome. Nothing like laughing. You might be upset with me, though, because I find funny things that happen to other people. You know?
No, that's normal.
That's what makes me laugh. Somebody falls down or spills a drink or knocks something
sure.
over. I'll laugh my arse off.
Right.
You know?
Well, my husband finds a slapstick. He loves slapstick, too. People slipping on a banana peel, he's hysterical. He's just funny.
Or people actually slip on banana peels?
Or slip on the ice in a parking lot in front of Market Basket. Hilarious, you know. You know, but you know what that's about, really?
You're killing me. Stop it.
When someone's laughing at an accident, you know what that's... Have you ever thought about why do you laugh at people's accidents?
No,
you're not a mean person.
No. You're talking about a car accident or just like an everyday...
When something weird happens to somebody else and you're laughing, well, part of that laugh, Chris, is... I may be unpacking something you don't want to know about, but part of that laughter is inner relief. Thank God it's not happening to me. Like unconsciously, you watch something bad happen. Something happens to somebody else. They fall. Like on television, it's constant. People falling down flights of steps, having car accidents. And at home, you're watching, thinking, what a great show. And then you think unconsciously, oh my God, I'm glad this is not me. And that laugh is a release. Because you don't want you're identifying with another human who's having pain, but it's not happening to you, so you're okay.
But it's a healthy release.
Yes, it is.
You need to get it out.
It's good to laugh. It's good to laugh no matter what. I think under any conditions, it's good to laugh.
Now, do you come in and do these seminars with businesses?
I do.
And make everyone have a good day all of a sudden out of their dreary cubicle-ridden life or their warehouse, wherever they're at?
Good question. In the world of business, and I do specialize in healthcare. Like I just did a program last week for Neshoba Valley Medical Center. And what I do with the staff, whether it's a corporation of a bunch of lawyers or a bunch of nurses and doctors, we want to increase productivity and improve the bonding and the cohesiveness of the staff so they get along better. When people get along better, they're higher functioning as a unit and they get better results at work.
Sure, absolutely.
So my programs involve communication skills, learning to say yes when you mean yes, no when you mean no, and laughing, again, at the paradoxes of the job situation. Like if you have a stack this high of paper that needs to be processed by tomorrow, you can laugh at it, or you can be a victim and say, oh my God, I'll never keep up, what's wrong with me? And the self-talk of how we talk about it. So the training involves, the cognitive piece involves how we speak to ourselves and how we approach our problem, and how we ask for help with it versus, again, the victim consciousness. Oh, poor me, poor me. You know, pour me a drink. I mean, what's going on? You know? So the work I do with work situations is called team building with laughter. Instead of laughter therapy, it's called team building. And the team building involves communication skills, negotiation skills, and also the experiential part is the same. We do laughter meditation, laughter yoga, and laughter therapy exercises to help people laugh to bond.
You got to lighten up every now and then. I can understand how valuable you would be to one of these companies where everyone's miserable in the cubicle on day-to-day life, just kind of sitting there and typing and filing, and you can come in and kind of bring some levity to the office and even get them more productive.
It is true. Well, when people are having fun, and it's been shown that I have some great studies that are medically peer-reviewed journals, Chris, that when people are laughing, it actually improves their memory and retention, and their cognitive ability goes up. They also have more creativity. There's more electrical activity between the left and right hemispheres of the brain, of the corpus callosum, mm-hmm. which stimulates creativity. So there was a study done on executives who, when they laugh for 15 minutes, they're solving problems quicker, they're coming to solutions faster and better.
I don't see executives ever laughing.
Well, this is, we're working on this.
So stiff, you know?
If I take a stand for the possibility that in every hospital and medical center and company, there is an on-staff laughter therapist or laughter trainer to help people move through their challenges with a lighter perspective.
Wouldn't that be something?
Yeah, that's
we could
my
see
stand.
Some of these stand-up comedians from the late 80s resurface with work.
Yes.
I could like that.
Well, anybody who's doing stand-up, if you're listening, any stand-up comedians, if you happen listening, you could get this training. There's a training you can do for non-licensed people that's like a two-day training, and they could learn some laughter therapy techniques.
Oh, so you could get them in on the biz.
Yes, they
could. Very
cool. They should call me.
Absolutely, and they could call you at 978-455-0660. Good segue. True radio professional here. That's Lisa Wessan. Mirthmaven.com, 978-455-0660, and we will be right back. I fuss and quake and cavitate. I try to speak.